Humphrey back there. She's working for tips also. She's been doing a great job serving us coffee. Round of applause for the barista. Hey, what the hell?
Didn't have to all tip at the same time. It was just a reminder.
You know? It's love. Thanks.
And I think he was joking about the separate tip jar.
Okay, well,
I'm not sure.
Still your pleasure.
There was no obligation. Thank you.
But thank you guys for gathering around a nice little coffee shop. We've got a great thing going here. You should be very lucky to have a place like the Bazaar Cafe, where weirdos like me can come out here and recite poetry and even throw some political politics into it. It makes me feel enmeshed in the loneliness and the longing of all things. When I think about people like Les running a cafe like this, I have to ask myself, what would I rather be?
I guess most things are better left unsaid. Kiss them and put them off the bed. And then quiet sinking ahead. This is not you. This is not me. And so it is. Can we agree?
Sometimes I swear to you, I will hear an exhausted sofa sigh, longing to be a hammock tethered between two palm trees, swaying in a tropical breeze. The hammock sighs, longing to be a magnificent bed in a luxury hotel, where two champagne-sipping sophisticates meet for illicit tryst. The cigarette lighter that they use after their stolen hour sighs in a crazed desire to be the eternal flame, illuminating a graveyard of forgotten soldiers who gave their lives in a forgotten war. The forgotten war sighs, I wish I were just a quiet evening at home.
We are strangers underneath the roof, and we rub each other till we're smooth. We're just rocks and live on a fruit. This is not you. We are not one. We are not two.
Do you ever think that those practical number two pencils that accountants use, do you ever think those pencils ever fantasize about drawing bawdy pictures of urban sophisticates in a luxury hotel? Does the luxury hotel ever dream of dropping its facade of rectitude and becoming a flop house, quartering a poet sprawled on an exhausted sofa, scrawling unpublishable verse while being pestered by bill collectors on telephone, stroked disgusted of tormenting multitudes for niggling sums, so the telephones themselves begin orating the Sermon on the Mount? Does the Sermon on the Mount ever fantasize about being a Vegas lounge act? Explosion of memory. We might hear the tale of a fleck of lint floating in the Bazaar Cafe that was once part of a soldier's bootleg, which he gave to his beloved to lace her corset the night before he died in a forgotten battle, in a forgotten war. A fleck of lint that was once part of a bushman's pelt, which contained the tooth of a saber-toothed tiger, which evolved into an alley cat, which was gutted to make the strings of a violin, which entertained elegant guests in a luxury hotel. But time on its hands to float in the air and sing of love, of war, of mythical beasts, of beauty, of poverty, of sadness. And that fleck of rent now drifts unnoticed into your beer, and you drink it down, and it sees the joys and the sorrows of your life, until you too are buried, forgotten in the earth. But you will rise again as grass, which is eaten by cows, who go to slaughter and are served in a luxury hotel and washed down with a beer. And we all get to have a Saturday night at the Bazaar Cafe all over again.
Hell yeah.